So ayan na guys, papasok tayo dito guys. Ganda ng ano nila dito guys, oh. Yan oh. Pero parang nakakatakot kasi glass yung ano niya. Yan. Yan, naka-step tayo guys sa glass, oh. Tapos sa baba, yung parang old basement siya guys. Ayan. May mga ano doon sa baba. Pero pwede akong umapak dito guys, oh. Yan. Glass ito. Ayan guys. Ito guys, yes. Butang sa likod ko.
The Eurasia plate collected with the African boom, yes, and it came upside down, and we had volcano explosion, yes. The lava went up to the sky, and then came down, and the crust of the earth cracked, and it came upside down, and it created a mountain range. We came out above the sea level 20 million years later, and that was the first part of Cyprus, the Rhodos Mountain.
Wow.
And then we had the creation of the second mountain range in the north, Pentadactylos. Yes? So it was the sea in the middle. Here it was the sea. So what happened after the ice age? That means snow melted from the mountains and it came down with the rocks, with the soil, and everything filled up, and we created Nicosia. So that's the reason nowadays there are sea rocks just like here. You see the window next to me? All these rocks with the remainings of fish. We call it fossils. Fossils, yes. Is the shells which existed in the sea. It became dry, yes, and we have the footprints of the seashells on the stone. So these are the fossils. Amazing. And again, some more over here, you see? Shells inside the soil. And then let me show you something very interesting. A long time ago, when the ancient Greeks came here, they learned us, they taught us how to mine. That's the time we are Greek nowadays, thanks to the ancient Greeks. And look what the ladies were doing. They were doing embroidery on the wall. This is what we have here. You see? Yes, with the stone, they were holding the thread and they were doing embroidery, yeah? Like the carpet on the floor, like the clothes. That's how they used to make them. And let's continue and see the evolution of the ceramics. But that's how Cyprus used to export copper and bronze in the old days. And these ones were very big, about 37 to 40 kilos. Yeah. Please do not touch the windows, huh? Ladies, do not touch the windows, please. Don't touch anything. It's not allowed. Thank you. So that's how we used to export the bronze and the copper. And that's what made Cyprus very rich in the very old days. And that's the reason everybody used to believe that Cyprus took its name out of the name of the copper. But no, it's the opposite. It's the copper, the mineral, that took its name out of the name of Cyprus. Because an old name of Cyprus used to be Aiskoprum, a very ancient name of Cyprus. And now, join me. We're going to go upstairs and see very interesting things. Thank you.
Kaya tayo, guys.
We're going to go upstairs?
Yes. Ayan po yung aming tourist guide. Follow the leader.
This is coins on your left, coins, yes, money, coins, which go back to the Byzantine years. You see how they are? Like a bowl, huh? Yes, yeah. curved. Back to the Byzantine years. And we continue. It was this group of soldiers, let's say, the crusaders, who tried to deliberate the holy places. What is the holy places? Jerusalem. Jerusalem. To deliberate the holy places, because the Arabs of Sarazan were trying to capture the holy island, the holy places. So that's why the crusaders, these, let's say, soldiers on the horses, with the costumes, with a cross, something like similar to samurai, yes, in your country. So they tried to deliver the holy places. So a group of them were named the Crusaders, the Hospitallers of Saint John. These were monks in the beginning. They used to live in the monasteries. They were monks. So they were trying to liberate the holy place of Jerusalem. And they took the sword, and they were trying to throw the Arabs away. So this group of crusaders, of Saint John, they came to Cyprus. So this was one of their sword. And what they did, they built a castle, Colossi Castle. Anybody want to Colossi? Yes, over there. They built the castle there, you may see it when you go there. Very good. And they make their base there, their headquarters, the grand commandery, we say. That's the reason they learn from the locals how to make the wine, red sweet wine of Cyprus. And that's the reason since then we name that wine Commandaria. Bravo, the big commandery. So Commandaria wine. Yes, and we used to export the wine. And that's what made these crusaders very rich. So this were the French. And then the Venetians, the Italians. Okay, now let's see what sort of clothes they used to wear and what sort of plates and glasses they used to have. It was all made of a cooked match. Pottery. Let me see. Okay, now let's see what kind of clothes they used to wear. She was wearing this one. Swimming.
Say this down.
It was when King Richard the Roman had came to Cyprus, was going to deliver in Jerusalem here. You all know the Limassol Castle, yes?
Yes.
Bravo. Before there used to be a church there, so he, the King Richard got married there to Berengaria. Berengaria from Navarre, from Spain, yes? And 1 year later, he said, okay, the food is very nice in Cyprus, the drink is very nice, but I must leave, I must go and deliver in Jerusalem. So he put an advertisement on internet, Cyprus for sale.
Oh,
there's a joke, huh? No internet then. It was the year 1192, huh? 1192. So he said Cyprus for sale. So who bought Cyprus? The French king, Guy de Lusignan. He was not a king then. He was only a rich person. He was in Palestine, huh? But because he was suffering from the Arabs, he said, okay, this is very nice. I buy Cyprus. So he bought Cyprus and came here. So that's how he named himself king. Huh? Himself put the crown. He became king of Cyprus. And all of the Lusignans, the French, ruled Cyprus for 300 years. Please, all of you, come in. If you can move a little bit, ladies, so everybody can come in, because I want to show to you a very important win now. Please. Yes. Yes. I wish. No. This is the queen, the beautiful queen that I want to show to you, Catherine Cuarnaro. She was the last queen of the French era here.
Ah.
Look at her. She's very beautiful, and a lot of people wrote about her beauty and her beautiful dresses made of silk in combination with precious stones. Huh? You see? Yeah? Okay. Not too close, huh, to the paintings, please. The guy is looking. And this queen was originally from Venice. She was Italian. She was from Venice. But this was an arranged wedding with the French king Jacob II. So they arranged this wedding. But then the king died, so she stayed alone with her baby. So the very clever Venetians, Italians, who wanted to make commerce in the Mediterranean, you know, to sell goods, the ships up and down, to make a lot of money. They said, the queen is on her own now, so let's make an agreement. So they made an agreement. They sent Catherine Cuarnaro to Italy, Asolo, north of Italy, and they started ruling Cyprus. So that's how we had the French here. Huh? And clever Italians, huh? They stayed here for about 100 years. So everything that we see in this room has been dedicated to the Venetian, to the Italian era.